Welcome back, children. Just a slight minor change I would like to make. We learnt about activity 1, 2, 3. We learnt in our yesterday's session. What is that activity 1? Let us once again see. Activity 1. Activity 1 is about matchstick. You observed matchstick for the arrangement of cells, cork cells. Okay. And then second one is you noticed onion peel. These two are what is the reason and cheek cells. These three are to observe that cell arrangement is present. That means everything is made up of cell. This is what Robert Hooke made us to understand. What did Robert Hooke make us to understand is, Robert Hooke made us to understand that every single individual is made up of, every single organism is made up of cell. For that, we observed one dead cell, that is matchstick, and one onion peel from plant, and one cheek cells from animals. So from this we understood that Robert Hooke, what he said is right. Now activity 4 is again onion peel, and activity 5 is again cheek cell. Now what is these three are to observe cells, which explains that these cells are present in every living organism, and these two experiments are to observe nucleus. As per Robert Brown, every single individual is made up of a cell, and every cell has a dense part inside it, which we call it as nucleus. And what are the differences that you noticed in this onion peel and cheek cells, that we are going to now just make a note of. For that, let us see. So how many activities did we do till now? We did 5 activities. 3 of them are to establish the fact that every individual, be it human, animal or a plant, are made up of cells. And the 4th and 5th activities are to explain that every cell has a nucleus present. This to prove Robert Brown. Now, what are the differences that have been noticed? First and foremost thing is that I need a chocolate. Now, this is onion peel and this is now what do you understand here? What do we understand by this? The difference between onion peel and cheek cells is the question that they asked. Now let us see. First thing is, onion peel onion peel cells look more prominent. Both are stained with saffronin, prominent. Boundaries are prominent. Boundaries are clear in onion peel cells, and in onion peel cells nucleus is to the periphery periphery. In cheek cells, it is more or less in the center. Now, what else do we notice? Why are the onion peel cells looking more prominent? Is because of the cellular arrangement. And when cheek cells are not looking that prominent, because of their cellular arrangement. And boundaries are clear in onion peel cells because they have, why are they prominent? Because they have cell wall along with cell wall plus cell membrane. Because they have cell wall plus cell membrane, while on animal cells only have a cell membrane. They don't have cell wall. That's why it looks more rigid. This looks more rigid. This looks more rigid because of the presence of cell wall. It looks rigid, and because of absence of cell wall, it is not looking prominent and it is not having a clear boundary also. And onion peel cells, nucleus is almost to the periphery. And why is it to the periphery? That we will learn later. And in cheek cells, more or less the nucleus is in the center. These are the differences that we noticed. But the common thing for both of them is that cytoplasm is present in both of them. In which, in both of them, what is there? Cytoplasm is common. Cytoplasm and nucleus is common. Nucleus is present in both. Present in both. The common things are cytoplasm and nucleus are present in both. And both have other organelles. Both have other organelles for its proper functioning. Proper functioning. So this is about the difference between the plant cell and animal cell that we understood, right? Now let us know about the diversity in cells. This is not just the diversity we are going to discuss about. In plant cell how it is, in animal cell how it is, we just understood. But is that it? No. Let us know, let me wipe the board. Cells are negligible size, like very tiny. But does it mean that all cells are tiny only? There are cells which are long, for example, nerve cell. Nerve cell is wrong, a long one. And very tiny cells are there, bacteria which we cannot see with our naked eye. And there are cells which we can see with our naked eye, and biggest cell is ostrich egg. So there is a diversity. And what are these other things? And shapes of the cells are also different. All these things we are going to learn in the diversity of the cell. What are we going to learn? Next topic is diversity in the cells. In the cells. Now, shape also. It is not about size only. Shape of the cells are also different. For example, let us see. I wish that you will be able to understand what I am drawing now. This is green in color. It is a single celled, microorganism. Unicellular microorganism. It is green in color. And what is it? It is Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas. This is Chlamydomonas. And then it's easy to draw, right? And few other things are like this. Okay, let's not draw that because we don't see them at all. So this is Escherichia coli. Escherichia coli, a type of bacteria. And then what else? Uh, amoeba. And then this is paramecium. Paramecium. And then Euglena. See, these are all unicellular organisms. What are they? They are all unicellular organisms. Chlamydomonas, Escherichia coli, Euglena, amoeba, paramecium. Not only them, there are many other living organisms which are unicellular. And because they are unicellular, are they all looking alike? They are not looking alike. Are they all living in the same way? They are not living in the same way. Are they all functioning in the same way? No, they are not functioning in the same way. So what are these differences that we are going to learn about in our present topic? Now let us see. Amoeba. Amoeba is easy actually to draw. Let us see. However you draw and you say that is amoeba, anybody should accept. You are very lucky for that. And then, right, that is it children. Just one small dot and one big circle you draw and then you remember the names. Enough. This is called pseudopodia. Pseudopodia. What is pseudopodia? Pseudo means false. False, like not true. Podia means feet. That means pseudopodia means false feet. That means false feet. What is the use of our feet to move from one place to another? So pseudopodia is also for moving from one place to another. And then contractile vacuole. Contractile vacuole. There's a lot we can learn about these things, even if it is a minute microcellular organism, I mean microorganism. Contractile vacuole, that means it is like a food vacuole. From the water, a speck of it, it will take inside, and because of Brownian movements, the movement of the Brownian movement, the food particle will break down and it is absorbed by the animal, I mean organism. And then you have cytoplasm. And then you have nucleus. And then you have cell membrane. This is a amoeba. This is an amoeba. You want to draw a complicated, beautiful structure for amoeba? Let us see. Yeah, this is also amoeba. This is also amoeba. You want to draw beautifully, you draw however you draw and then you say amoeba. Nobody will have to say no. They have to accept. So, this is the diversity in cells. Tomorrow, what are we going to learn is observing the cells in a leaf. Microorganisms we observed. And much more is there to learn about it. We will learn. And next topic, tomorrow what we are going to learn is about cells in a leaf, that means in plants, how it is. Before that, once again, just let us have a recap. Till now, how many scientists did we learn about? Anastasius, Fischer, Kircher, Swamander, Ian Swamander, Anthony van Leeuwenhoek, Robert Hooke and Robert Brown. These five scientists you remember. And what did we learn till now? We learned five activities. We learned five activities which explain us that all the living organisms have cell and all the living organisms have nucleus. And what we learned again is the diversity in cells. Tomorrow we will learn about the cells in the leaf. Thank you, children.